Hi, this is Mel Wolverson from IT Training at the University of Missouri, and I'm going to cover the iPad app for Box. So, when you first log into Box, this is what you will see. It shows you all files, so if you've uploaded any files from another computer, from another device, perhaps your iPhone or a similar phone, then they will appear here, folders and files. On the left-hand side up at the top, you can always get back to this spot by just clicking on the folder in the top left. Now as I scroll down, you can see that some of these have a check mark and some of them also have a little lightning bolt symbol. The check mark means they are ready for viewing, they are available, they're uploaded, and then the lightning bolt means that they're available offline as well. So if you lose internet access, you will still be able to get to those files. And the ones without a lightning bolt, those you will need to be online. You will need internet access to view when you come back to the app. So that's something to keep in mind while you're working with your files. Now the next icon down on the left-hand side is the lightning bolt. And that just shows you all of your files that are available offline. The next one down is your history. It looks like a globe. And then the next one down is the Box One Cloud. It just tells you different apps that are available to use. And then the last icon on that left is a search. So you can search through any files that you have on Box, and you just type in whatever you want to look for. In this case, I'm looking for Note, and it brings up everything that has Note in it, even if it's not the full word, right? Even if it's part of the word, it'll go ahead and look through and find your stuff. And then you just click on whatever you were looking for to open it up and look at it. Okay, so the search is going to be really helpful, I think. I think that's going to be a really helpful feature. The last icon down at the bottom left, that's where your settings are. It gives you lots of different options. You can change your notifications and all of that sort of thing. Okay. So let's go on to the next section. If you want to modify an item, tap, hold, and slide to the left to see all of our lovely different icons. You have delete, and what I just tapped on was the lightning bolt, which will make it offline. So now this file is available offline. It's a fairly small file, so it didn't take very long. And now if I click on the lightning bolt in the top left, you can see that now I have two files that are both available offline. I think that offline feature is going to be really big because you're going to be able to get things offline. Notability. You can create, over on the right hand side, you can create a new document. You can add a new document via your photo library, or you can even take a photo using your camera. You can create a new folder to put things in from here. I'm just going to make a new folder called Test, just so you can see how this works. And I'll tap Save to keep that folder. It's going to take a second, and then if I scroll to the top, you'll be able to see that that folder is there, and it's called Test. Now, I'll open it up, just tap on it to open up a folder, and now I think I should add something to this folder, so you can see that happen. So I'm just going to choose an image, and it's just a screen capture from earlier, from a previous tutorial. I'm going to click Move to a folder. I'm going to choose my test folder. And that's all there is to it. Now that file is in the test folder, and I can get to it whenever I want. Right? And I could go to the next file and do the same thing if I wanted to. Now if I tap Open the test folder, I can see that that image is in there. And just to show you, you can get rid of things, you can move things out of that folder fairly easily by just sliding it to the left like I did before. And you can use that to share or delete or edit or make offline those files. In this case, I'm going to rename it, or at least show you that you could rename it. So just remember, slide left to modify a file. That's really the easiest way to modify an individual file or folder, actually. And we're back to our all folders. If you need to modify multiple different files, perhaps delete multiple different files, up in the top right hand side you have a circle with a check mark on it. And that check mark, if you tap on that, that will allow you to tap on the little circle next to multiple different items like I have here. And I can quickly move or delete, in this case I've chosen delete, those three files, and it'll do all of them at once. So you could delete a whole folder of files or just a whole bunch of files after a project is done very quickly, even from your mobile device. Okay, the next little icon looks like a sideways V is sharing. So you can send files to whoever you need to via email or other things. Thank you for joining me for this IT training on Box, the iPad app. A nice walkthrough. If you're interested in other videos that we have made, you can click on Full Playlist in the middle of the screen. That'll take you out to our full playlist with a variety of different videos. Thanks for joining us.